Hey, SureCallers and Certified Installers. Today we're doing things a bit different. We'll be giving you a hands-on training that'll teach you how to terminate the 400 coaxial cable with our crimp-on connectors. By the end of this video, you should be an expert coaxial cable terminator. For demonstration purposes, we'll use 400 coaxial cable because it's a very commonly used cable type, but the process for terminating 600 and plenum cable is exactly the same. You'll just need crimpers that are specific to those cable types. Step 1. Make sure you have all of the necessary tools. These tools include a soldering gun, a pair of wire cutters, stripping tool, crimping tool, razor, and possibly a heat gun if you want to use the included shielding. And in our demonstration, we will be going through that step. Just like I mentioned before, if you're cutting plenum cable or 600 cable, you'll use the same tools but opt for the cable-specific crimping tool instead. Soldering the connectors is not a requirement, but it is a strong suggestion to ensure that the connector's integrity is not compromised. Step 2. Cut the cable so that the end is straight. You may need to squish the end of the cable a little bit after this step to make it circular again. Sometimes the cutting process can flatten the cable, and you'll want to make sure that it's nice and round for the next steps. Step 3. Make sure the stripper setting is correct. 400 and RG11 have the same diameter, so make sure that your stripper is on this setting. Insert the end of the cable so that it is flush with the end of the stripper. Close the stripper and rotate fully 2 or 3 times. Be careful, you don't want to strip the core of the cable. Open the stripper when you're done. Do not pull it off. Step 4. You should see 2 cuts. The one closest to the end will allow you to strip the cable down to the core. The second will pull off to reveal the wire braid and foil insulation. Carefully fold back the braid so that it lays over the black outer jacket of the cable. Make sure it lays nicely because you will need it later. Step 5. Before placing your connector on the cable, make sure the exposed core is 3.9 millimeters long. The stripping tool should have made it this length, but it never hurts to double check. Take the center pin and solder it to the end of the cable. Once again, soldering is not required, but it is strongly suggested. Step 6. Slide the O-ring onto the cable, then put the end mail connector onto the end of the cable. Fold the wire braid over the connector and keep it in place by sliding the O-ring toward the end. Step 7. Finally, crimp the end of the connector like so, and as an extra precaution to make your cable weather resistant, use the heat gun to seal the plastic shielding. There you have it. Hope this video will help you the next time you're customizing the cable length of a signal booster system. If you have any questions, leave us a comment and we'll get right back to you. If you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe and check out one of these videos for more helpful information just like this.